What we've got here is failure to communicate.
Vi skal have en vækstplan, og den skal for det første indeholde en ægte kickstart af dansk økonomi. Det er derfor, vi bliver ved med at tale om, at vi skal fremrykke offentlige investeringer.
I'm sorry, I'm allergic to bullshit.
Men det er tilbage til udgangspunktet. Vil du godt lægge hovedet på blokken og sige, at jeg kan garanteret skaffe 75.000 jobs, hvis vi prioriterer på den her måde?
Ja, ja. Når vi netop laver et forsigtigt skøn, at det er muligt, at der er endnu flere jobs i det her.
Vi kan glæde os over, hvis du sammenligner os med Portugal, med Spanien, med Grækenland, med UK, med andre lande i Europa, så er vi i bedre form.
Det vil sige, at få gennemført regeringens politik, oplæg om at lave en efterlønsreform og andre tiltag, der gør, at der bliver balance i den offentlige økonomi frem mod 2020.
Det er jo både økonomi og vækst. Og der har vi jo været meget aktive i forhold til genopretningsplanen eksempelvis.
It's three lies. Same as Peter did to Jesus for the cock crowed.
You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
Is that supposed to be funny?
Do I look like I follow politics?
First of all, the topsoil on which food is grown now is nothing more than a sponge onto which we pour chemicals that we get from oil and natural gas. And without those chemicals, the soil has been turned into a junkie. The soil is worthless. So when you plant a crop now, what happens is you drive an oil-powered machine, drives along, and it plows. Then you drive another oil-powered machine, and it drives along, and it plants. And then you irrigate. Well, how do you irrigate? Well, that water is pumped by pumps that are powered by electricity. Where does that electricity come from? In the United States, it's either coal or natural gas. So next thing you do is come along and you fertilize it. All commercial fertilizers are made from ammonia, and the feedstock for ammonia is natural gas. So you have ammonium nitrate fertilizers that are then sprayed on by another oil-powered vehicle. Then the crop dusters come along that are powered by oil that spray pesticides that are all made from petroleum. Then when it's time to harvest the food, what do? You drive another oil-powered machine and you harvest it. You use another oil-powered machine to drive it to a place where it's processed. Then you wrap it up in plastic, which is oil, and you put it in another oil-powered machine and you drive it X number of miles to a food distribution warehouse, an oil-powered machine to your supermarket. The way food is grown, produced, and moved around the world today, it's an enormous waste of hydrocarbon energy, which doesn't make sense. Why do we have strawberries from Chile? Why do we have spinach from China? Why do we ship anchovies halfway around the world to be packaged in tin cans and, you know? There are 10 calories of hydrocarbon energy in every calorie of food consumed in the industrialized world.
I just want to say one word to you. Just one word.
Yes, sir.
Are you listening?
Yes, I am.
Plastics.
I'll tell you what I like about Chinese people. They're hanging in there with the chopsticks, aren't they? You know, they've seen the fork. They're staying with the sticks. I'm impressed by that. I don't know how they missed it. Chinese farmer gets up, works in the shovel, works in the field with a shovel all day. Shovel, spoon, come on. There it is. You're not plowing 40 acres with a couple of pool cues.
Channel 4 News has been told by a top Saudi oil industry insider that the American government's forecast for future oil supplies is a dangerous overestimate.
OPEC countries do not care about what might happen about from now, 20 years from now, or 30 years, or 40 years from now. They care about what they get now, today.
One of the most common questions that people ask is, do you think that the peak oil that you write about is going to produce a global catastrophe? And my answer is, it already has. There are people dying right now as we're speaking. There are people dying right now over oil. There are governments being twisted and changed and seized over oil. Climate is changing because of oil. And there's a small group of very, very wealthy people who are getting richer and richer because of oil.
Okay. Disappointed! Son of a bitch!
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I break your concentration?
I must say to you that the State of the Union is not good.
Did you know millions of Americans live with debt they cannot control? That's why I developed this unique new program for managing your debt. It's called Don't Buy Stuff You Cannot Afford.
Oh, let me see that. If you don't have any money, you should not buy anything. Sounds interesting.
Sounds confusing.
I don't know, honey. This makes a lot of sense. There's a whole section here on how to buy expensive things using money you save.
Give me that. And where would you get this saved money? I think I got it. I buy something I want and then hope that I can pay for it, right?
No. You make sure you have money, then you buy it.
Oh, then you buy it. But shouldn't you buy it before you have the money?
No.
Why not?
It's in the book. It's only one page long. The advice is priceless and the book is free.
Wow, I like the sound of that.
Yeah, we can put it on our credit card.
What one person can do, what you can do, what each one of us must do if we're going to have a decent world, a good world in which to live, and certainly if we're going to leave a healthy planet to our children and grandchildren, what we must do is personally wake up to these issues and then be an instrument of awakening, if only for one other person. Tag, you're it.